With all the fad diets, health crazes, daytime doctor shows, and sensational news stories out there, it can be difficult to know what foods and activities are really in the best interest of our health. Well, my guest today has been fighting against all the hype for years, providing a clear, science-backed resource of free nutrition education. And now, he's refined thousands upon thousands of studies into one easily approachable and engaging text, explaining what the science actually says. Not one to beat around the bush or mince words, the book is appropriately entitled, How Not to Die. Hi, it's Emily from BiteSize Vegan, and welcome to another Vegan Nugget. I'm so excited and honored to welcome back Dr. Michael Greger of NutritionFacts.org. If you missed his previous video series covering all of the common nutrients of concern when going vegan, you can check it out later here and linked below. Dr. Greger is a physician, a New York Times best-selling author, and internationally recognized speaker on nutrition, food safety, and public health issues. He has dedicated his life to providing accurate, unbiased, science-based, free information on nutrition and overall health on his nonprofit website, NutritionFacts.org. Today you'll hear what inspired him to take this path in life and why he's so passionate. Dr. Greger's book, How Not to Die, came out on December 8th, 2015, and instantly became a New York Times bestseller. The book reveals the top 15 causes of preventable death in the United States, and Dr. Greger's daily dozen of foods that add years to your life. Without further ado, let's hear from Dr. Greger.
In the book, you tell a personal story about what it is that even got you on this path of talking about nutrition. Could you share a little bit about that?
It's nice to have an opportunity to kind of share how I got involved in all this, because, the websites and NutritionFacts.org, I just want to be the science. I want to kind of take me out of it and just be like, all right, here's the science. But all this other stuff I've always wanted to share, I never had an opportunity to until the book came about, like, what do I eat? How do I make it all happen? And so that's what I actually start the book with is, how I got into this, why I'm even a doctor, why I practice the kind of medicine I practice today, why I'm so kind of compelled to dedicate my life to this work, and it's because of my grandma, who was diagnosed with end-stage heart disease, age 65. I was just a little kid when, the doctor sent my grandma home to die. Confined in a wheelchair, crushing chest pain. She already had so many open heart surgeries, she basically ran out of plumbing at some point. You get so scarred up inside. Nothing more they could do. Her life was over, age 65. And then she was watching 60 Minutes, and there was a segment on this crazy guy named Nathan Pritikin, who claimed to be reversing heart disease with his new clinic in California. She somehow made the cross-country trip and became one of his early patients. In fact, she's featured in his biography as one of his early success stories. He talks about Francis Greger, shows up in his wheelchair, they wheel her in, put her on a plant-based diet, graded exercise program. Within a few weeks, she's walking 10 miles a day, goes on to live another 31 years till 96, getting to enjoy her 6 grandkids, including me, inspiring one of them to go to med school, and living long enough to see him graduate from med school. And that's why I practice lifestyle medicine.
So your book is addressing the top 15 causes of premature death. And I think most people tend to think that, maybe I have a few unhealthy habits, but it's not that bad. So as someone who is routinely surveying the state of nutrition in America, could you tell us, exactly how bad is it right now?
It's pretty bad. I talk about how sad the standard American diet is and how few even get a serving of fruit a day, a serving of vegetables. 96% don't get the recommended 3 servings a week of beans. 97% of Americans fiber deficient, 98% of Americans potassium deficient. And these nutrient deficiencies are because people aren't eating enough plants.
In your book, you reveal the daily dozen, the foods that, we should all consume on a daily basis. If you had to choose the most powerful disease-fighting food, what would it be?
Probably greens, dark green leafy vegetables. We need more greens. Now, that's not what the data, the data suggests nuts are actually the most healthful. Fruits and then nuts are the two most health-promoting. But I think people tend to eat fruit people tend to eat nuts. What they don't eat is greens. And so in terms of something I really want to encourage people to eat, dark green leafy vegetables and the legumes, beans, split peas, chickpeas, and lentils. These are two foods we really got to get into people's diets. But the number one killer, dietary risk factor in the world, not eating enough fruit.
It's interesting because, like, and I know that you've done videos on this, but you hear people talking about the sugar in fruit and diabetics are avoiding fruit. Where do you think that kind of misinformation comes from?
Oh, well, I mean, I think it's just this, you know, so we realize that industrial sugars, high fructose corn syrup and table sugar, bad for us. Why? Maybe it's this overload of fructose causing liver problems and all sorts of other problems. And so, hey, where's fructose? Found in fruit, so fruit must be bad too. Okay, how about, but if you look at the science, it's just absolutely not true, right? Fruit helps liver health, helps with hypertension, helps all the things that fructose, right? I mean, it's just like, and in fact, I actually have a video coming up. I mean, we evolved to eat fruit. In fact, we're actually more frugivores than folivores. So we are designed to eat fruit. And then that's the number one risk factor, dietary risk factor for death is inadequate fruit consumption. And in fact, if you take diabetics, split them into two groups, half are told, limit your fruit, half are told, eat more fruit, guess who does better? The diabetics told to eat more fruit. Packed with fiber? I mean, come on, people.
Okay, so your book, of course, is focusing on the healing power of diet and exercise. Is diet and exercise really enough to reverse and even cure diseases, or are there times where other medical intervention is sometimes necessary?
Even just diet alone can reverse disease. How about our number one killer? Number one killer of men and women, the number one reason you and everyone you love will die, heart disease, can be prevented, arrested, treated, and cured with diet alone, as Dr. Esselstyn has shown. Other lifestyle medicine pioneers, such as Ornish and Pritikin, use a combination of lifestyle approaches, including a plant-based diet, plus exercise, stress reduction, all these other things. Esselstyn, just in terms of lifestyle interventions, just use diet, showed the same remarkable reversal, opening up arteries, in some cases, without drugs, without surgery. Now, are drugs and surgery useful in some indications? Absolutely, particularly for acute conditions. You break your leg, you want someone to set it. You have an infection, you want an antibiotic to cure. But chronic diseases, we're talking 85% of our health care dollars go to chronic disease. Diabetes, high blood pressure, obesity, dry heart disease, maybe these cancers. These are chronic diseases for which modern medicine has little to offer. In terms of treating the cause of the disease, because the cause is lifestyle. It's not medication deficiency.
You have a chapter on healing suicidal depression with diet. Are there any times when mental health issues are beyond the realm of dietary influence? Or are there any statistics about, is it even possible to know when something is caused by lifestyle and when something might be, you know, some other pathology?
I think diet plays a minor role in mental health. I mean, the surprise with that chapter is it plays any role at all. And in fact, it plays the most, so plant-based diet is found to be the most powerful intervention in improving mood within a matter of weeks. No other diet has ever been shown to have the effects. But having said that, that doesn't mean that it's going to, I mean, just because it works better than everything else doesn't mean it works particularly well. And there's lots of mental disorders for which you have no data on diet at all. All we have is the depression and anxiety data. But it's remarkable. Hey, people suffering from these mental disorders need all the help they can get.
Okay, for a lot of people, diet comes down to finances, or at least that's what they'll say. And there's this predominant belief that a plant-based diet is expensive. How do you respond to that assertion?
It's ridiculous. I mean, what could be cheaper than like a can of beans, sweet potatoes, cabbage, frozen vegetables, like a can of canned tomatoes, like whole grain pasta? Like, I mean, come on. I mean, so in fact, right, there's a book, like vegan at $4 a day, right? And it's like per family member, $4 a day, period, right? And so you can eat healthier than anybody else, cheaper than anybody else. more environmentally sustainably than anybody else. It's the same diet.
I hope you enjoyed hearing from Dr. Greger. How Not to Die is available now, and 100% of proceeds go to charity. Check out the link in the description to grab your own copy. And head over to nutritionfacts.org for free daily videos on the most current nutrition science. I'd love to hear what you thought of what Dr. Greger had to share. Have you lost a loved one to preventable illness? Have you known anyone who's reversed their conditions? Let me know in the comments. If you liked this death-defying nugget, do give the video a thumbs up and share it around to help others find true health. If you're new here, I'd love to have you as a subscriber. I put out fresh content covering all aspects of veganism every Monday, Wednesday, and some Fridays. To help support BiteSize Vegan's educational efforts, please see the support links below or click on the Nugget Army icon there or the link in the sidebar. Now go live vegan, stick to the science, and I'll see you soon.
People while rocking around the street may know more about nutrition than the doctors, and we all know how much people walking around the street know about nutrition, right? Yet, people continue to go to their doctors for unhealthy eating advice, right? And what their doctor may be telling them may be killing them.